So I've already shown you how to track text and images in DaVinci Resolve, but today we're gonna take it to the next level. I'm gonna show you how to stick a video clip to a moving object with Hologram Effect. And all the tracking techniques and features that I'm gonna show you also work in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. Here we go. Okay, so first of all, on my timeline, I have the video clip of myself, and this is the video clip of the spinning globe. I'm gonna put it on top of the other clip and then cut it to the same length. And then select both clips, right click, and create a new fusion clip. Now it looks like the top clip disappeared, right? But let's go to the fusion page. And look, there's two media in nodes now, where usually there's only one. So media in one is the video clip of me moving my finger, and media in two is the spinning globe. We can already scale it down maybe. So just select the media in two node and add a transform node. That's this icon right here. And then just scale it down there. And now you can really see what's going on. The bottom video clip and the top video clip of the spinning globe. Okay, then tracking. Select the media in one node. So the node or video clip with whatever object it is that you want to track. In this case, my finger. Hit Shift plus Spacebar and add the tracker. Now, if you're in DaVinci Resolve Studio, you'll get a tracker box that looks like this. That's the IntelliTracker box, which usually is the best option because it does a really great job at tracking almost anything, but you can still switch to the point tracker here. And the point tracker, that's this box, it looks a little bit different. That's what you'll see if you're in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. But either way, what you have to do now is just put the tracker box over the object you want to track. Doesn't matter if it's the point tracker box or the IntelliTracker box. And make sure that the playhead here is at the start of the clip. Move the tracker box over my finger. You can also play around with these settings here to create a bit more contrast between the object you want to track and the background. And then just hit track forward and let Resolve do its thing. Once it's finished, all you need to do is select transform node here, the one that we've added before. Right click here on the word center and then connect tracker one offset position. And that's it. Now the globe will use the tracking information from tracker one to follow my finger. But you can still move its position here using these pivot settings. See? There you go. But we don't have the hologram effect yet. We just tracked a video clip now. That's it. Now, if you want that hologram effect, you have to make sure that you're using a video clip with a black background, sometimes called an overlay. Neon overlay, hologram overlay. See, all these will work. I found mine here on Envato Market for just $8, but you can also find free overlays. Just Google it and I'm sure you'll find a bunch of free ones. But yeah, so let's create the hologram effect now. It's super simple, you'll see. First of all, I'm going to add a mask because I don't know if you can see it, but if I zoom in here, in the background here, it's not just black, there's like stars in the background. So I'm going to add a mask so that we only see the globe to avoid that when we create the hologram effect that we still see the rectangular shape of the video clip because of those stars in the background. Know what I mean? But if the background is 100% pure black, you probably don't have to do this. Anyway, so select the media in two node, the one with the spinning globe in this case, and I'll add a circular mask. See, and that's it. And then I can resize it a little bit, feather the edges, and there you go. You could of course also create a custom shape mask by using the polygon here. Okay, anyway, and then le moment suprême, just select the merge node and set the apply mode to screen. And boom, a super cool hologram effect. A tracked hologram effect. Now, if you also want those extra effects like resizing and blurring the globe when it gets closer to the camera, go check out my image tracking video. The one where I show you how to track images. And I'll link it in the description. But the workflow is exactly the same for images or videos. So go check it out and just go to the second part of that video. Okay, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.